Hello.
The today's session is the R programming data structures. So using the R coding. So yesterday's session up to some basics. The today's session starts from the data structures in R. So the data structures mainly it is a classical in four different ways. That is the vectors, matrices, and data frames like that. So vector. How to create the vector in R programming? So like this, the vector creation, a list of numbers such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So while at the time of an R coding like this, A is equal to C of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in typing in R editor. The C is indicating that command to create a vector. Here the C. The C letter to create a vector. It is acting as a one command. A is the one variable. A is equal to C 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. Now I want to go run A. Your output is like this. This is the simple creation of the vector in R programming. The second term is the matrix in the data type. So matrices are the two-dimensional data structures in R and arranged in rectangular layout. Matrices can be contained only one data type, like this. While at the time of typing in R editor, like this. So Y is the variable, Y is equal to matrix, that is the command, and 1 is to 20. That means from starting letter 1 to 20 letters. The number of rows is equal to 4, number of columns is equal to 5. That means you have to define now how many columns are required, how many rows are required. So I want number of rows is equal to 4 and number of columns are 5. So number of rows like this, 4 rows and 5 columns, 5 numbers. Okay, like this. This is the command type. While at the time of running on Y, your desired output is like this in R environment. To create the simple matrix creation, it is the one type of data structure in R. The third one is the data frames. So data frames is very, very important. A data frame is more general than a matrix. In the different columns can have different modes, not only for the numbers, numeric, character, factors, or whatever it is, it will be a single application. So like this is the one of the variables. C means to create the command 1, 2, 3, 4. That means a vector creation. And E is the one variable. C is equal to like some of the colors like red, white, red, are not available. The data is not available. So C is equal to true, and false. So right now I want to create a data frame. So my frame, that is the variable name. That is the desired, whatever name you can take, my frame. Is equal to whatever the data dot frame. Data dot frame, the desired variable names like this. Now running on my frame, the output is like this. So DEF is the variable names. Each and variable will get like this. E is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And E is equal to some colors you have to indicate in variables like red, white, and red, and not available data. And F is equal to true, and false, like this. You have to create a simple data frame. The command line is very, very important. That is, the command is data dot frame with variable names. Whatever the variables you have to assign, that variable name must be indicated like this only. You will get the answer like this. And fourth one is the list. This is the one type of data structure. That means vector and matrices are in two ways to work with the collection of objects. List provides the third method. Unlike a vector and matrix, list can hold different kinds of objects. So how it is like this? The example list like this. So how to type in R editor? So this is the prompt of R, the interpreter prompt. X is the variable list. That is the command. So name is equal to like Prasad, comma, and nationality is equal to Indian. And height is equal to 5.5, marks is equal to create the vector like 95, 45, 80, double brackets is closed. So how many names of a variable you have to test, like names of X, automatically the system respond like this, name, and nationality, and height, and marks. These are the names in the sequence. So you want to go for a particular value must be required, that means X. X means it is a variable, dollar symbol, by name. dollar symbol, name. You want to name, for example, at the time it will be indicating the result. You want to nationality, for example, X dollar sign I. Dollar sign nationality. Like you will get the Indian. In case of you want to go for height, X dollar symbol height, you will get around 5.5. You want to go for mass, for example, X dollar symbol mass, you will get answer like this. This is a simple creation of the list in R programming. Okay. More examples in next session. Thank you. Thank you very much.